I'm very happy to be with the Brothers of St. John here in this house of Blessed Gabriel Michael. And I remember first going to your mother house and speaking to your founder, Abba Philippe. And I nearly spoke 1 hour with him, and I also explained to him about the need of the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa. And I said, if it is God's will, it would be good if the brothers would come to Ethiopia. And that is probably 8 years ago. And then after some times, he died. But the other superior general who started the work, who continued the work of the community, he sent first brothers to look around in Ethiopia, because I invited them to come and see first Ethiopia, because Ethiopia, because of its history, is a different country with its Judaic influence, Christianity influence, Muslim influence, and also the brief history of the Catholic Church. Is very important that the brothers come and see for themselves. They came and they saw, and I said to them, what do you want to do? Can you help us with the youth office of the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa? And they said yes. And so the community came, and they started living in this house of Blessed Gabriel Michael, which of course is the residence of the retired diocesan priests of the Archdiocese. It is destined for that. The cardinal lived in here, Cardinal Paulus, the first cardinal here in Ethiopia. And he lived here, and many elderly priests lived also here. And in fact, Father Thomas lived for some time together with the community here until he passed age 94. So all the brothers who live in this house will live more than 90 years old. So there is hope for you young community members of St. John. The evangelist. So I'm grateful that you have come. And after 7 years, I'm grateful to God and to the intercession of all the saints you have been praying to get the land, to get the land in Addis Ababa, to build the first priory in Ethiopia. I know you have foundations in Western Africa, but in Eastern Africa it would be the first foundation, as far as I know. So this is God's gift to the brothers, the dedicated work you have done, and the great example you have given to the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa. I don't know what the other religious communities in the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa called the Brothers of St. John. In other parts of the world, you are called the Petit Gris, or the Petit Gris. In Ethiopia, I don't know what they call you. I have to ask your neighbors in this area, and also the sisters who are living in this area, what they call you. But on the door, I have seen well written, Yekdus Yohannes Gadam, and the Orthodox like that. So they see that you are religious, dedicated to follow the Lord, and also to leave the evangelical councils of poverty, chastity, and obedience. This you have been teaching by your habit. because there are not many religions who dress the habit. Probably the Cistercians and the Capuchin fathers here in Addis Ababa. So I would like to thank you, and also I would like, thank the works you have done, not only in the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa, but in the Vicariate of Hawassa, where you have been taking many youth for retreat and for summer camps. This year you have taken them to Dreda, but you have visited also, I know, Gondar, Adigrat, and the other places in Ethiopia. And Ethiopia is large, is big, and it requires a lot of planning and engagement to work with the youth. Not only with the youth, I have also asked you to help the Francophone community, which you are doing well. I'm grateful for that, because we have a big Francophone community here because of the African Union, and many ambassadors, many persons working in the embassies, international organizations. And besides that, I like also your work, your community work of adoration. And I don't know if some people still come for adoration here, and this is one of the place of adoration. So in the new place also, if this service could be extended, would be really great. Most of the people who come from West Africa, Central Africa, South Africa, who are used to adoration, would like to get this service. And also when there is adoration, when there is mass for the expatriates, let's say in this country, you would offer them also the sacraments and the opportunities, especially for penance, reconciliation, which is very important, as we remember this year of mercy, the Pope Francis saying to the world, what the world needs nowadays is mercy. I think he was touched by what is happening in Syria, in the Middle East, and people suffering. And he is saying that, you know, we don't speak about it, but we are somehow in war, you know, third world war. In pieces, here war, here disaster, and so on. And he's still praying that the world needs mercy, and we all need mercy. And the church needs mercy, the communities need mercy, Ethiopia needs mercy. Now, you know, with the situation here, we need mercy. Our neighbors like South Sudan, Somalia, Eritrea, and Yemen, we need mercy. So this is the year of mercy. And I know also you help a lot with the Missionaries of Charity. This year has been exceptional with the canonization of Saint Teresa of Calcutta, and is a big thing for us. And in Ethiopia they have 18 houses, and the brother, the community of Saint John have only going to have one house. So 17 are still will wait for you to compete with the Missionaries of Charity who serve the poorest of the poor. But so we need the intercession of Saint Teresa of Calcutta for her love for Jesus, her dedication to serve the poor, and being a saint of peace, and she got the prize of peace. And we hope through your prayers, we hope Pope Francis, who has gone now to Armenia, Georgia, Azerbaijan, all these places, why can't we invite him to come to Ethiopia? If he comes here, we don't know if he's going to stay at the house of the brothers, St. John brothers, But I don't know if he uses your cars. Some of your cars are luxurious. Small ones he wants. Probably the one you brought. He might like that car. But he needs a driver. Yeah, you will drive him around. So we will pray for that also. You know, he has been to Kenya, Uganda, Central Africa. Now the Archbishop of Bangui, Central Africa, now he is a Spiritan, you know, and he is a Creator Cardinal, I think in November. And Pope has been there to make peace between Muslims and Christians. And the big challenge here also in Ethiopia is how to make the Christians strong. The Orthodox, the Protestants, the Catholics, who are still a majority in this country, and how to peacefully coexist with the Muslims. All this will be part of our work in the Archdiocese, and you are not alone. You are part of the religious community of the Archdiocese of Addis Ababa. And when you have your own center will be a special center for retreats, and also where people can come for a day or two for prayers and recollections, which is very, very important. And I thank you for the work you have been doing for the youth.